Welcome to the first video in a five-part series about the five essentials of sailing. These are the five different things that we can adjust or change in the boat to sail efficiently. Coming up, we look at sail setting, balance, trim, board, and course made good. This series builds on the basics covered in my video about how a sailing boat works. If you haven't seen it, I'd suggest you watch that first. There's a link in the description. These videos are to support your background knowledge as you learn to sail on a suitable practical course. In this first video, we're going to look at sail setting. The sails allow us to harness the power in the wind, so we need to understand how to set them properly to sail efficiently. We're going to look at airflow around the sail, how to use the telltales, effective use of a jib, and how the sails can create turning forces on the boat. A quick recap on airflows then. A laminar airflow is what we're aiming for most of the time. This happens when we use the sail to deflect or bend the wind, creating a pressure difference and therefore a driving force. Think of it working like a wing, only the physics is a bit different because a wing is much more three-dimensional. A turbulent airflow is what we would normally experience when sailing on a run, where we are presenting as much surface area to the wind as possible. The wind can't go through the sail, so we also create a pressure difference and a driving force. Telltales can be fitted to a sail to help us to see what the wind is doing. They should always be fitted in pairs with one on either side of the sail. This boat has two pairs of telltales fitted on the jib. Here we can see that both pairs of telltales are flying parallel, showing us that the air is flowing nicely around both sides of the sail. We have a good laminar airflow and the sail is efficient. If the windward telltale starts to fly forwards or up or down, then the sail is too loose or undersheeted. You can see this happening now. This also happens when you're trying to sail too closely to the wind, pinching into the edge of a no-go zone. So what's happening? When the sail is undersheeted, you get turbulence or a small recirculation of air towards the front of the sail. The wind by the sail is normally going forwards, hence the telltale flies the wrong way. If we continue to turn towards the wind, or to ease the sail out, then the sail will start to lose even more power. The luff is the front edge of the sail, and this starts to flap first. As the sail becomes more and more undersheeted, more of the sail will flap. We can either sheet in the sail more, or bear away from the wind a bit, until we restore the correct airflow around the sail to get the telltales flying parallel again, like this. If the leeward telltale is flying forwards, or up or down, the sail is oversheeted. It's pulled in too tight. The sail is presented at too steep an angle so that the wind cannot bend enough to flow along the front side of the sail. So, the wind swirls round to fill the gap, usually pushing the telltale forwards, possibly up or down. Easing a sail out, or luffing up, should restore the sail to the correct angle to the wind. If we are sailing on a run, with a turbulent airflow, the telltales are not really going to tell us anything useful. Because we have turbulence around the sail, the telltales could be pointing anywhere. We can use the telltales at any time to check that we've got our sail set properly. We can also use them to help us to steer the boat on our best possible close-hauled course to sail upwind. Keep your sails in tight and watch the telltales. If the windward telltale starts to fly incorrectly, you've turned too close to the wind and you'll feel the boat losing power. Bear away a bit to correct it. If we turn away too far from the wind, the leeward telltale will be wrong. We'll also be generating less power from the sail whilst sailing further than we need to through the water. Luff up again until they both fly parallel. Most double-hander or family dinghies will have a jib. A jib adds more power to the boat and works in conjunction with a mainsail. It's important to set both the mainsail and the jib together. For example, we sheet in both sails at the same time. Here, we can see how the mainsail and jib would work together, each with a nice laminar airflow. The aim is to create power from a jib whilst not stalling the mainsail. The space between the jib and the mainsail is called the jib slot. This should normally be parallel so that the back edge of a jib matches the shape of a mainsail. If we oversheet the jib, we can close the jib slot so that the wind cannot get to the mainsail. We will create a lot of turbulence and lose power from both sails. If we undersheet the jib, we lose power, but also the boat will try turning into the wind and it will feel really heavy on the rudder to keep the boat straight. This is because of how the sails interact with the hull. Each sail has a certain amount of sideways force on the boat, which increases as we sail closer to the wind. The daggerboard or centreboard resists the sideways movement so that we can go forwards. The sideways forces from the sail should normally balance around the board, more or less. By design, a boat will normally try to turn slowly into the wind. If we only use one sail, we upset the balance of the forces. Sheeting in only the mainsail will cause the stern of a boat to be pulled downwind more than the bow. Pivoting around the board, this will cause the boat to want to luff up. Pulling the rudder hard to stay straight is just making work for yourself because the boat isn't being sailed properly. Similarly, if we pull the jib in without the mainsail or oversheet the jib, the bow gets pulled downwind, making the boat want to turn away from the wind or bear away. Pulling the sails in and out together will help to keep them balanced to help the boat to accelerate in a straight line and under control. The more we can understand all the different forces acting on the boat, the more able we are to control it. A few top tips. Beginner sailors often have their sail oversheeted when sailing downwind. If the sail is flapping, this is an obvious indication that the sail isn't right. But if it's in too tight, it doesn't necessarily look wrong, and we do still have some power. The telltales can help here. Also, look at the length of your main sheet. You have to pull it all in to go upwind, so you'll need to let just about all of it out again to go downwind. You can also recap the points of sail I've shown in the video about how a boat works. The link is below. It really helps to get used to how the boat feels while you're sailing it. Practice sailing along with the telltales flying properly, then turning gently so you can feel how the boat loses power as the telltales change. By getting a really good feel for what the boat is doing, you won't be staring at the telltales the whole time. There are other things going on around you. The telltales are really sensitive to what the wind's doing on the sail, so it can be pretty hard to keep the telltales flying constantly. Don't be too hard on yourself, and don't forget the basics. If your sail is flapping and you're going nowhere, you don't need the telltales to tell you that something's wrong. Getting the telltales consistently right is really polishing off the edges. Next in the series, we're looking at boat balance. Feel free to ask any questions below and hit the like button if you found this video useful.